So yeah, we have Dr. Shivani here. She's with SRJ Netralay Indore, and her topic is transition from a fellow to a consultant, a rocky terrain. Over to you, Dr.
So very good afternoon. I would like to thank UCE for making me a part of this wonderful session. I'll be sharing my journey and transition from a fellow to a consultant. And I hope by sharing the challenges that I faced and the learnings I had, I'll be able to help a few of our young ophthalmologists here. I completed my MS in ophthalmology from SMS Medical College, Jaipur. So after completing my MS, I had a few basic questions in my mind that was I a good clinician back then? Was I ready to practice in a private setup or in a good city? And very importantly, was I an independent surgeon? So here is where the role of fellowship comes into play. By getting training in the subspecialty of your choice, you definitely become a better clinician. You learn how to manage different types of cases of your specialty. You gain confidence to handle OPD independently and get ready to practice in a private setup if you wish. So I did my long-term fellowship in glaucoma from Narayana Netralaya, Bangalore. I had the privilege to get trained by one of the best, Dr. Sati Devi. Yes, I had this feeling of elation that, okay, post-graduation done, fellowship done. Again, back to those same questions. I was confident that I could handle independent OPD, manage glaucoma medically, perform all the laser procedures. But was I a confident surgeon? As I started seeking job opportunities, the reality hit me that it was just the beginning. I got the opportunity to join as a consultant at Regional Institute of Ophthalmology, Sitapur. I treated high volumes of glaucoma and cataract there. And more importantly, I made some friends for life. So when we face this transition from a fellow to a consultant, there are certain challenges that we face as to psychologically that how will we do everything on our own. We already have the clinical skills, but we have to learn to implement them and refine them further. And of course, being able to operate confidently, independently. We have this safety net above us of our mentors and seniors who are there to guide us in difficult cases in OPDs, who are scrubbed beside us when we operate. This all is taken away when we complete our fellowship. But friends, confidence is the key here. You know your subject. By the time you complete your fellowship, you have given certain years to ophthalmology already. So hold on to your confidence. And as we know that learning never stops, you'll have to go back to literature and books till the time you practice. This is probably one of the most important slides of my talk. The harsh reality being when we work in a high volume setup or in a medical college, we are actually keen on completing our OPD on time. But incorporating few things in your practice really makes your patient happy when they walk out of your chamber, like greeting them when they walk into their chamber, patiently listening to the history, taking a good history, just discussing about the diagnosis that you are making, what all investigations, why are you advising them, and the management options that you are offering. Take out a couple of minutes to answer their queries if you are offering any surgical intervention as well. You can see how scribbled my sheet is. So yes, good documentation is very important, whether you are a PG or a fellow or a consultant. Mention your clinical findings, the treatment that you have offered. Human mistakes are always possible. So please just check that the correct medication is mentioned in the correct eye, that you have mentioned about the prognosis of the disease. As I practice glaucoma and with any other super specialty, this holds very true. That you have explained the risks and benefits involved with the surgical intervention, if you have advised any. Keep attending conferences, keep yourselves updated, keep meeting your colleagues and seniors. Dr. Rituja will be speaking about it next. And we will always come across tricky cases, new cases, unusual cases in our OPD. We'll have to take them for surgery as well. So get back to your mentors, do your homework, see the literature, see the videos, and you will enter your OT very confidently, like I gave my best when I did my first Ahmed glaucoma valve implantation. As a young surgeon, as an independent surgeon, we are so much focused on the surgery itself that we tend to overlook a very few basic things. please take out time, counsel the patient about the surgery you are going to do yourself. Prior to getting scrub, please check whether the consent has been signed by the patient and the attendant at the required spaces. Perform timeout prior to the surgery. Learning never stops, and you learn best from your mistakes. So if you have a chance to, you know, access to video recording in your OT, record your surgical videos. Go back home, look at your videos. They'll really make you learn as to where you went wrong and how you can improve your skills. That's what I did in Sitapur every single day after my OT. When you are about to operate on difficult cases, discuss them with your colleagues, with your mentors. They will always guide you. And I had Dr. Karan besides me in the OT. One more way to learn is to teach. So when I was in Sitapur, I trained a few fellows in glaucoma, and every time I taught them, I learned something new. So if you are in an institution, you have trainees with you, take out time, participate in their teaching schedule, and you will definitely improvise. So the expert at anything was once a beginner, so start off with your journey, and all the best. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Shivani. So we'll move on to
We still have a minute. So if anyone has any questions regarding how to, like, I think the main focus here is once you're done with your fellowship and transitioning to a consultant is a big leap, actually. And she has nicely pointed out as to, you know, where you have to actually, you know, you have to understand where you fit in and where you want to work after this, whether you're working in one tier or two tier or three tier place, and what is the demand of the patient and how polished you are actually going in as a consultant. So actually, sometimes you can go in training in a place where you can have more hands-on and that less there is less burden when it compares to when you're doing it in as a solo practitioner. So that is one thing which she has talked about. And the second thing which she actually emphasizes is counseling your patients. So counseling something becomes very important because a lot of the times, as she said, that we are only focused on the surgery, that this is the surgery we want to take it up. But we actually are not able to titrate what the patient is about, and sometimes there is a big difference of communication. So even if you give your best to those sort of patients, they are ideas, and you know, they, when you see them post-op, they're doing very good, but still they have issues. So that is one thing which has been actually very nicely highlighted. So anyone, if anyone has any other questions?
I'll just add a point. So you're learning continuously every day. We both, Shivani and I, we were in, right next to each other in the OR. And so we used to teach each other something new every day. So I would discuss something with her, how do we go about this glaucoma case? Like the first endothelial keratoplasty in the history of Sitapur that I did was when it was a case of single-eyed patient post-AGV. So Shivani was there right next to me. Okay, now how much should I trim the tube? How much should I go about it? Because it was very different than a normal desect that you're doing. So you learn from each other a lot, and you learn from your fellows as well.